Hello and welcome back to The Darkest Dungeon, episode 71. Apparently I can't stop playing. Noises off stage, apologies for that. That's what happens when you spend your life with somebody else. Don't recommend it. Now, rude. In the last episode, I think we decided to go for this wield boss because what we've got here is Erasmus, not Martinus, with the ability to heal the worries off of Dutch here, who is currently at zero stress. So even with the plus 30% stress damage, I think we should be able to take control of that. Plus we can probably use a trinket to offset that to some extent, even though that will offset Dutch's damage. But I think that's okay, because we could, if we wanted to, take a trinket with us. Can we? I've never tried. We'll see. Or maybe hopefully just get one. And then we're going to go for this Brigand 12-pounder, which is going to be a lot more difficult than the previous Brigand 12-pounder. Excuse me, headphones. Stop breaking. There we go. But I think we're on only level 2 of this. Right? Maybe. And we decided to bring along Dark Trojan with, again, no real major issues. Ah, I forgot to check. Now, I'm going to cheat on the wiki for this, so you'll forgive me, but you know, I've done this before, you can't be surprised. But I want to know if we can move the Fusilier and therefore cause them not to bite the touch thingy and explode the cannon. Kill the Matchman. Doesn't actually say, but the Matchman will go last. I think we knew that already. Yeah, I think it doesn't matter where the Matchman is. So it doesn't matter if we have Dark Trojans come hither, except that that will move it into range if we need to. Knockback 2 could also do the same thing if we used it on something in the second position. But I'm pretty sure the cannon itself will be in the third position, which means we're going to be wailing away on it with Erasmus's higher damage attacks if possible. And basically just dancing around and hoping not to get hit. And don't forget, of course, we have new Doug here, Doug the Second, Vivaphonics of the Second, to bolster us with their very high level, for their level, healing abilities. So I'm hoping that this goes well. We could take Holmesy, but I kind of don't want to, because A, two diseases, which is going to be a problem, and B, halfway to being stressed out already. So let's have a look at our trinkets. Start giving these people what they need. Now, on this unit has no major malfunctions. A bit more stress damage is fine. Cleanliness. We'll only meditate. It's fine. Those two kind of cancel out. That's pretty good, because that means this one has basically no effect. But one of those two has no effect, which fills up a slot. And these are very much part of their psyche now, so we can't get rid of them easily if we wanted to. Oh, three of them are actually basically playing off one another, which is great. Which means these are the only two that are affecting us in combat. Or in the dungeon at all, so I'm going to hope that they don't switch out. So what we've got here then. Chance to turn any miss into a hit is good. Less stress damage and cove is not ideal at this stage, but could be in future. More heal skills while camping is also not very good. More move skill chance, possibly something we want to deal with, want to take. More scouting chance, maybe, but I'm thinking maybe plus 2 speed. Obviously you'll want to give Erasmus the quick draw charm again, because we want to make sure they get out of position, or into position, however you want to look at that, before we actually, you know, ruin everything. But okay, let's go with the speed here. Oh, pardon me for drinking mid-sentence. I'm thirsty, so I'm going to. Speed 10 here versus speed a billion here is going to be great. Let's just put this in and see what we end up with. Plus 8 speed, so that's going to be 17, which is way more than 10, so it's very likely that Erasmus will be going first in the first round. Below 26, not really. More heals received. Could go well on somebody. Well, as we find them, let's give them to the people we want. We've got a sniper's ring here. We've also got some worry stones, I believe, which will reduce stress. less stress damage on less speed, so that's okay. Minus one speed. Don't really mind Dutch going last. To some extent, I do, because it means that the chances are that if we don't kill the Fusilier with everybody else, then Dutch is the only person who can do it, and that could go horribly wrong. But I mean, this is quite nice, and we've got. We'll see if we can take things with us to assist. We'll take our Sacred Scroll, and we'll take our Tome of Holy Healing, which is great. Having low speed on the Vestal is fine. Martinus Erasmus will also get. Dun dun dun. Kind of want more damage. Because we're going to be wanting to beat the shit out of this cannon ASAP. Now, one thing we could be thinking of doing is actually taking our Payas here and trying to get them using the. No. We want to maybe take the Houndmaster and try and get them to use the weakening. The debuffing protection thing, but I think the cannon itself has a huge debuff resist as well, so honestly I don't think that would work. So I think this is actually our best party, or at least a decent party for this situation. I really want just a massive amount of extra damage. Yeah, we're going to be using melee skills mostly to do the damage to the Fusilier. Unfortunately, I can't sort of not take. Well, I guess we don't need accuracy necessarily. Especially if we can take. You know, just straight up. Damage on range skills? Do we have any. We don't have any Arbalist specific trinkets, which is strange because we have so many of everybody else's. I assume there are some, but. Oh, we'd have this one. Not useful though. More damage, less speed, more stress. Don't really want that. I don't want anything that increases stress damage. Less 20% stress damage. I think we take this. It also increases our speed to give me a little bit more confidence that we can go before the enemy, which is useful. But if we can replace this accuracy with damage, that would be nice. Book of Rage, not really. More crit and more dodge could do it. That's just straight up 10% accuracy range skills, which is nice. Really not seeing what I was hoping to see. Ah! This seems like a much better idea, for the reason being that the thing that Dutch is going to be mostly responsible for is making sure that the matchman dies. Which is going to be human. Yeah, good thinking. So we're there. We've got everybody's got trinkets, and they seem a decent set. Let's provision. See whether we can open trinkets up and put them in here. We can't. That's fine. Take a couple of these. We are going to the Weald, but we don't. Again, when we do a boss mission, we don't worry about bringing back wealth. We worry about winning. Take all of that, I guess. Some of that. A couple of these. There's always things that the herbs will help with in the Weald, so I think it's usually a good idea to take some medicinal herbs and less food. It usually seems to pay off. We've got our trinkets. I'm going to take a full two stacks of torches, because although it could be three tiles to the boss, three rooms to the boss, it could be loads. It is a medium mission. And of course, we want to make sure we get there with as much HP and as much light as we can. Take some anti-venom, because we don't have anyone who can cure that. I'm hoping that mostly the Vestal will be able to keep up with the damage that venom will cause us. But if we end a fight with blight on us, it would be nice to be able to get rid of it in many situations. I think this is a good embarkation, and of course everyone will get 33% resolve XP and more damage, and having this extra 15% damage, which I'd forgotten about, I will come clean, will certainly help us against something as tough as the cannon. So I think we're ready. Let's check our skills. Got the right skills. And I think I'm quite likely to use this until the boss, so I'll keep that on. Can't change. Well, we could change those. Less dodge. That's actually really good. Probably gonna do that. Which means you're perfect in the third position. You have got everything that I want. Poison darts is not going to help us in most situations. And you have got... I mean, I do like blind fire. That's a really good one for the rest of the place. Now, I don't know whether this one will be useful for... Oops. The boss fight. I don't know whether there's going to be marks or debuffs or stuns at all. But I think blind fire is not going to be useful. So we should definitely... have this option, but mostly we're going to be using sniper shot, and maybe even we'll get DT here to mark the unit at the back just to ensure that that fusilier dies, but I think we're okay.
The wild whispers of heresy roused the rabble to violent action. Such was the general air of rebellion that even my generous offer of gold to the local constabulary was rebuffed. To reassert my rule, I sought out unscrupulous men skilled in the application of force. Tight-lipped and terrifying, these mercenaries brought with them a war machine of terrible implication.
Ooh, he brought it on himself, he did.
Smell of sulfur.
That's a long way to go. So I'm glad we provisioned well.
The war machine is close.
It's nice to know about these. I'm not sure why a blockage is a book, but never mind. So I'm guessing the boss is here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And it's not that bad, but it's still quite a long way. It's very ruinsy. Just kind of hoping for the serendipity of having just a square layout with only 3 or 4 between us, but whatever. Now someone's going to open. Oh, no one opened this. I'm going to not deal with that because I'd like to make sure that we don't have any trouble with blockages if we can avoid it. Ah, look. Trap disarm 100%, here you go. Again, I believe that these are now adjusted for the trap that you're facing, so 100% is 100%. Not convinced, but the evidence is there. Alright, our first battle is around the corner. Please, no slimes. What did I just say? Pretty sure I said, please, no slimes, because that means we have to deal with the slimes. Instead of the stress-dealing unit, but at least we can get rid of stress. There is that. You've already got 30% damage versus human, which is great, but you can't hit that one. So maybe we stun this. Move it back. Doesn't get rid of the corpse, which is odd for a... Well, it's not that odd. I tend to assume that any moving thing like that will destroy a corpse, but it doesn't. Let's use this so that we don't take any stress damage that we don't have to take. I'm not going to kill that. Quite reasonably likely to kill that. I think we do.
Destroyed.
Very good. You are marked. That's okay. We might as well... You got high dodge? You have got high dodge, so we'll do this. Get some torch back as well. You dodged the dodge dodgy. That always happens with Vestals, actually, and shame on me for forgetting. But the Vestal's accuracy on that is just so piss poor. Luckily, it didn't come around to bite us in the arse, but it very much could have done. Let's just check this. 90 base, so it's not quite as accurate as many other things. But it's not as inaccurate as quite a lot of EG Hellions, who have things like 60% accuracy on some things. It's 90% accuracy, so it's 90 accuracy. I assume it's percentage for some reason. I'm not a fan of the fact that we've already got a second obstacle, but I'm also kind of glad that I brought enough shovels to deal with it.
The light, the promise of safety.
So hopefully we can actually make... Oh, there's a freaking trap. You didn't even deal with it properly. I'm so good at just walking on traps that I'm well aware of.
Witnessed by his own eyes.
Oh, this is not fun. What do we do here? I guess we lunge at 102. It doesn't have any protection, but still. Crit. No crit. Fine. I mean, these are all actually human, which is really nice. There's a lot of human, even though they don't look human. If you sort of mentally deparse what's going on here, it's kind of gross, but it's, yeah, it's human. In theory. So we will probably want to... I guess we can just finish him this. Oh, yeah, perfect, actually. That was really good. Obviously a massive overkill, but I feel like a crit even when you don't need it is kind of useful. That's okay. Have you got high dodge? Yes. So let's try this again, and this time, don't dodge it. Here it's a hit, 51%. So that dodge, combined with that accuracy, is basically... You got... A call chance, really. Got a 50% chance, and you got a high debuff resist, so... The chances of that working was not great. 26. Resisted the move, but at least we got the unit we need. At this point, I think I might use Blind Fire, because it has... 7 to 15... It's actually shit. Give them no quarter. I'm very surprised that Blind Fire doesn't do a huge amount of damage to make up for the fact that it's inaccurate. Could stun it. It's got a higher move resist, but the stun resist is much lower. Resist both? Whatever. Stun again. Again, resisted the stun. Inconceivable. Not sure what this does, but I don't like it. We do have this mark. I don't think it is going for the marks unit, though. How have you... You've got some dodge, but this does damage versus marks, and so do you. So I'm going to mark it because everybody gets use out of it, but also this unit is going to last long enough that having a mark for 3 rounds is actually going to be valuable, rather than the usual, you know, the mark goes away straight away and you might as well have just shot it scenario. So in this situation, we just beat the shit out of it. 30 fucking 6. See, when it's got 102 damage, 102 HP, who cares? Three of these units can benefit from a mark, which will also work against the actual boss, the 12-pounder. Which is I thought it was a burger. This is fine. I think we'll dance around, maybe?
Yeah.
It's not good that it's your go. How far can you move? Kinda don't want to do that. So we might as well just use this. It does do some damage, and it's probably worth doing just some damage at this point. Now Erasmus can still... Can you lunge from the back? Yes. But I will move you forwards for now. Try and sort of... Oh, blind fight. Great. Try and sort of shuffle people around into the right order until we can lunge. Fine. I mean, that shuffle could have done a lot worse against us than it actually turned out to. No. I'm not going to open anything that looks scary or dangerous because, again, whenever we're doing a boss mission, we're here for the boss. Anything else is a bonus, but anything that could really scupper us, I really want to avoid it. We definitely want to have the biggest advantage we can upon arriving at said boss room. Bit of food at this point does not worry me at all. Honestly, hunger is actually quite a useful prop, because when it does proc, you get to legitimately eat the food that you were keeping in case of a hunger proc. So we'll do this all over again. If you could crit this time. Don't know why I bring you. So the stress damage here is kind of being offset by this quite a lot, which is really good. We don't need to use a torch yet. I think we just finished him this. I mean, it's overkill again, but it's the same situation. Oh, here we go. Oh, perfect. Everyone dodged it. I do appreciate that. You could kill it with a crit. Ah, it's a different type of unit, actually, so there is that. In this case, I think we judgment it. Slightly higher chance to hit, I think. Oh, it's the same chance to hit, but... I mean, it's going to die. If it hits, it dies, so I'm not entirely concerned about what the secondary effect is on the unit. It's not even going to be there anymore. You lose protection, but you don't have any, which is kind of annoying. We might be able to stun it and make use of that. I think we mark it. Honestly, I was deliberating because I don't know whether it's better to try and do more damage with DT and then let Dutch mark it, or the other way around, but then it occurs to me, because of shit, right? Stop min-maxing to that extent. You're both gonna... That's nice. You're both gonna get the opportunity to do damage as a result of that mark, so just do the damage. 12 HP is great. I mean, having a Vestal around to do at least guaranteed... Fine. But not fine, if you see what I mean. having a Vestal around to do at least guaranteed damage is great. You couldn't have dodged it with your plus 27 dodge or anything, just saying. But, of course, the amount of HP you get from that is capped. Oh! I was just going to say, it's capped unless you crit. So, we're just completely undone that entire round, except now we've got the Death's Door. Oh, for 5 minutes. I mean, I've got some food. You can have some food. Can you have food now? No. Throne Dagger doesn't kill it. So you have to not go first. This'll kill it. I think we should. It's worrisome because obviously now we can't actually heal Erasmus. I think this only happens once though. It doesn't stack, which is really nice. We don't get to heal Erasmus until the next combat, which is horrible. Put everyone back in the order that we expect. There's a lot of combat in this row, in this fucking zone. I'm not going to open that because it can stress somebody out completely if they see what happened. Again, with that one. Oh, heck.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted.
Please. Clear. Surprise, great. So we will get to heal Erasmus before the end of the show. Please crit. That's why you're here. I kind of wanted to kill this. I know it does a lot of scary damage. You crit, but not enough. That's okay. Right, and now we heal you for a crit. 10. 10 is okay. And then you throw skulls at people who dodge. Not dodge. Of course, it's the one person who's going to take the most stress damage right now. At least it wasn't a stun. And we are doing 15% extra damage ourselves. It just doesn't seem to matter. I guess this will be 15% harder if we weren't. Does that even make sense? Maybe not. So now we do this again. And now we don't have to worry about this much. That was probably our most annoyingest unit. I think I'll make sure that we can get another heal off on Erasmus if I can. Especially if Erasmus is going to dodge the damage that would make that not worth doing. Perfect. Two dodges. Means we get to shoot one, jump, chewy chomp, and then we get to heal Erasmus. Not a party heal, an Erasmus. Another crit, perfect. And then you can die, I guess. 9 to 18, so be it. So that was actually fine. Bit scary that Erasmus had to start that with basically no HP, but we did manage to claw it back. And here we get to have another freaking fight. 76. Oh, this fucking Joker keeps knocking out Erasmus to such an extent. Let's try and stun it early. Not great that we had to do that, but it did work. Because now, of course, Viva Phonix is in the wrong position. And you're bleeding, but not diseased, which is probably all I care about right now. We could kill that with just one hit. It's the same amount. Not quite enough. That's okay. Embrace the dark. Two dodges. Okie dokie. Don't want to know what that would have done. So now you get to have a go. Probably not going to kill it. But it'd be closer. And that's all we care about. But this could kill it. So let's do this. 51%. Six. We might as well kill the one we're more likely to kill, which didn't happen. Vestal can't hit. Shit. Honestly, I don't know how you're supposed to have a Vestal that is, you know, capable of doing damage if every single time you do anything, that bullshit happens. Do we lunge? I think no. Because I don't mind Viva Phonics being in this position for one more round. But at this point, I'm actually going to use a torch rather than try and use the light creation from that unit. And then we pick to the face this. Make sure it doesn't do any more rabid rushing. Which is fine. Then we can mark this for death. We'll mark this up ready. We're going to shoot this one. Get rid of it. It doesn't do any damage to it. There has been no damage done to this. But I think it's fine for now. And we have less dodge. I think we do a party heal, actually. Because inevitably we're going to get smacked really hard with a tree branch at some point. Everyone dodged that, which is amazing, because at this stage of the fight, we do not want people in the wrong position. Absolutely not. I think maybe we try and stun it. Or do we just do a lot of damage? I think we do a lot of damage. 20 is enough. It's only a fifth, but... I guess we lunge now? Crit mod 12%, so we could crit. We'll just do 22 damage anyway. No worries. Fucking yes. That's what we want to see. So this is basically on its last legs, and if we can stun it, poison spores is just blight, I think. Which is resisted, so I don't really care. We don't have the stun, we have the self-heal. How much damage? 6 to 12. No, I think we top everyone off. It's not necessary, because for once Erasmus had taken no damage, but... I'm reluctant. Stun. Succeed. Good. I wanted Erasmus to be in that position, just in case this thing was still alive in the next round, but it really looks like that's not going to be the case. We can heal ourselves and do damage to that, which is basically the two things that we need to do on that turn. So that's perfect. Everyone's at full HP. The only thing we have to worry about is Dutch's stress, which we knew we were going to have to worry about. We might as well open this, because we do have the keys necessary to do so. It's an unlocked strongbox, you dumbass, so fucking open it. It could still be trapped, I now realise. Actually, I don't want this. I want these. Right, well, that was a little bit terrifying, but okie dokie. Guess we just keep going. One more battle. I think we'll camp here unless we get a scout and know that we can camp here. Make sense? We did bring bandages. We haven't got much space. We don't need much food. Oh, okay. Antivenom then. There we go.
Packs laden.
What can we take? None of it.
Are often low on supplies.
I'm gonna get rid of this, really. The deeds are valuable. What's this? 250, 250. We want enough food to camp with, which is 8, and then 4 in case we get a hunger pain between now and then another 4 in case we get a hunger pain afterwards, but if that does happen, we can always have 4 in the camp instead of 8. I'm honestly tempted to just not take these. Ah, we've done it, we might as well, you know, hope for the best. Pray for the worst. Prepare for the worst. Well, there you go. So now we should probably make sure I need to have 4 food when we camp. So here's our possibly final round. Possibly final battle before we camp. Well, it will be the final battle before we camp, actually. Can we not have this fight over and over? Vary it a little bit, at least. Right, you can kill this.
Decimated.
It's excellent. Now you can... Can't hit that with that. I mean, a crit would kill it. That's the highest damage it could have done, which is great. Unfortunately, it's now one turn away from death. You actually resisted the curse, which is amazing. Appreciate that a great deal. This will do damage if it hits, which it didn't. But that's okay, because this... Oh! We should have just waited for Dutch to do it. Thanks, Dutch. Appreciate that, but also... Don't be poisoned, because I just got rid of... It's fine. I mean, as long as they're not doing stress damage, I honestly don't mind. And we can get rid of a lot of this stress whilst camping. And the thing that is causing more stress. So... I guess that's good. Less dodge is pretty much the only thing we can do. And a crit on that is very unlikely, but it happened. Right, stun it. And we can get in a position, yes, where... We can all take advantage of this 3-round mark to beat the absolute level ever-loving crap out of this thing. So it's now got the stun resist buff, so we have to hit it as hard as possible. 29 is a great number to see. You get to throw a dagger, which is going to be 13. It's an okay number to see. I was kind of hoping for a crit, if you don't mind, but there you go. And... Fine. Oh, you get to go, which is interesting, because I was going to heal Dutch, but I'd rather end the fight. It is done. That was really good. We've got a second one of those. Oh, Struth. I do want it. But what we can do, we can come back when we've beaten the boss. Don't forget. But don't walk into this trap, for goodness sake. We can come back when we've beaten the boss. Pick up... because we'll have more inventory space by then. Open up that chest. We will not open up this one. We might as well open this one. The sack is empty. Kind of not unexpected. But not ideal. And we scout. No scout. But we're fine. So I think what we do is move to this room anyway. There may be combat. There may not be. We just don't know. Oh. Fuck. This is not the right time for this game. And... I forgot to reorder the party. Well, it's stunned. It's unstunned. That's really annoying because I was hoping that we could, you know, get a benefit out of this. It's human and eldritch. It's got 102 HP like the other one, but it's going to produce adds on a regular basis. There's no protection. You can't shoot it, which is very annoying. So you're not going to be able to do anything until it summons something and it's at the back. Now, do we heal ourselves and increase our heals for the future, or do we just attack it? For 7 to 15 damage without a crit, that's not that great. So I think we... oh, you can't heal yourself, so that kind of settles that. Now, that was the highest roll, so I'm pretty pleased with it, but at the same time. Let's dodge. Didn't heal Dutch because we're in the wrong position to do so, which is kind of a pest, but... I suppose it's also fine. 23. It's possible that we just don't let this thing have a go. 22. It's gonna have a go. It got a go. That's fine. I'm pretty sure we can kill it on this round. Obviously, we can't use Erasmus to lunge now that it's at the back, but we can get rid of basically anything else in essentially one hit. So probably this one. Exactly one hit. That was perfect. Wasn't even a crit. Such a strong attack. Now we can heal Dutch. Which we should do. Not completely, but well enough. Now we can snipe a shot and probably... I was hoping for a crit to kill it, but I can't really complain. But it is in this position. So we can't hit it with that, but we can hit it with this, which is enough. Actually, I was probably slightly wrong to even concern myself with the fact that this encounter had taken place. We'll try and stun this and get ourselves into the attack position. It feels a little bit sort of rote, if you see what I mean. The fact that we keep doing this same dance with Erasmus. But it's so effective. It gives us the opportunity when we're in this position to decide whether Erasmus is going to do a pick to the face, or another shadow fade, or a thrown dagger. If we want to do another lunge, we shadow fade. If we want to kill something, if we want to stun something, rather, we shadow fade. If we want to make sure... something takes damage, we do any of the other attacks. It's actually... it's going pretty well. Are you still guarded? No, but we might as well kill this, right? What's we got here? 7 to 13. It's going to kill. It doesn't matter which one we use. We kill that one, and then we can focus on the rogue. Which we can't stun. It does have a high dodge, so maybe we should try to do this. Reasonably high dodge. I don't want to miss if I can avoid it. Perfect. And this unit, of course, has the ability to... if they're going to miss, it might actually be a hit anyway, which is really nice. We can't sniper shot, but we can blind fire. Blind fire with one target is just a shot. That went extremely well. I was actually very worried. We can't take it. Creatures can be felt. They can't, we don't need this many torches. Honestly, I think we get rid of the torches. We take the... the puzzling trapezohedron, and we move on. We don't need so many torches for that last corridor, is what I'm thinking. No combat. Great. Perfect. Camp.
Circle in the dark.
Eat.
The battle may yet be won.
Where do we get that extra food from? Don't question it. It is what it is. You can get rid of the worries now. We have this as well. Ooh. That's actually really good. Erasmus, use the snuff box on this particular unit. No longer has the worries. You can now swap this out. that you do more damage. Less dodge, more damage. Perfect. Houndmaster, we don't have. Now, maybe no one's in any way injured except for... Look at... This is an excellent run. I've got to be honest. I think I've been very lucky, but I'm going to consider that I've played really well. Now, one of these gets rid of... Does it not? I'm looking for the mortality debuff remover, but it might have been on the occultist that we had. I don't really need a scouting chance. We've got two preventions of nighttime ambush. Do we not? No. We've got one preventing nighttime ambush. Oh, here we go. Yeah, here's the other one. If has mortality debuffs... It's time cost 4, whereas this one... I'm sorry, I am completely confused. We have one, and it's this one. But honestly, I'm not sure we need to. But I think I will, because if we take too much stress as a result of a nighttime ambush because it's dark, we're going to be sad. So you had that and healed 30, which is great, but we didn't need it. What I really wanted was the one that removes that. But there you go. And now we just encourage this Joker here, I guess. 10 accuracy, 5 crit. What else have we got? These are time 2, so we only get one of them. All we get to do... There's a 25% chance we make it worse, so let's just do this one. Maybe we do this one? More accuracy and more crit? And then we can just pilfer something and see what we get. Food. Fair enough. Well, we rest. Dutch is stressed out, which was expected. Oops, just whacked my mouse. Not supposed to do that. But not as stressed out as we could have been. Find victory. I mean, we could have hoped for better, but we could have expected worse, which is how that goes. And I think we're in a fairly strong position. As a result of all that, we'll go back to the default party order or we'll forget. That was a trap. That's our stress back. Okay then. Smelly? Yeah. Bad times. What did you get? A blight. Oh, you resisted a blight. Okay. Doug. Sometimes a tree is just a tree. Are we ready for this ship? I don't think you're ready for this jelly. It's in the second position, but I don't think it's going to stay there. But if it is going to stay there, I'm going to be super happy. Do we lunge and make sure this dies? And then wail away at it with the other units? I think we do. Now, it's going to respawn one of those on every round, and we basically... The trick is to ignore these, because they're going to come back all the time. So we mark this. Yeah, it's got 220% everything resistance. But it can't resist our bonus to damage. It can't resist a mark. Slice and dice can be dodged, but it wasn't dodged. Blanket fire, more likely to dodge? Yeah. So I think we're going to be doing a lot of party heals to start off with here. We do get to sniper shot this for a reasonably large amount of damage. 5. It's not got this hugest amount of damage, but it's not brilliant. You crit the wrong one. You dick. Whatever. Reinforcements. We get our fusilier back. If we make sure it's in the second position, I think we're going to have our most likely... I think we're going to have the most attacks that can hit it in that position. So, honestly, we just keep smacking it. At this point, we try and... We can't stun it. We can stun this Joker. Get ourselves into our preferred attack position. It didn't happen, but, you know, 45% stun resist. It's not terrible. It's not great. Shank. Perfect dodge, because I was worried that I was going to have to focus the healing on one unit, which is not something I want to do at this stage. Because if we're going to keep getting... Oh, fuck. I didn't kill that. This is bad. Miss. Fucking thank you. What a terrible misplay. Well, we know now that it has to doesn't have to be next to it, but Jesus Christ, I completely forgot to do it. This is one more round, so we should still keep hitting it. 8 damage, that's really good. It's only got 75 HP. Right. Make sure you kill. It's at the back. That's the problem. Yes. Good. We've got lucky on one misfire, and I'm not going to make that mistake a second time. As long as we have any unit that can hit that Fusilier, we will hit that Fusilier. No fucking messing around. Now we need to put that mark back on. Fusilier's back. You are going to throw a dagger at it. I thought that could only hit the middle two, so I'm actually quite happy that it can hit this one. And that's exactly the right amount of damage. We can throw under. We can under-roll that run. We can under-roll that attack and not kill it with that, which is a little bit worrisome. But we've always got Dutch to help out. Until Dutch completely dies from a bleed. Dodge. Didn't dodge, but it was a zero damage, which is great. We're going to get a lot of XP from this, which is going to be swell. Just checking the Fusilier's not there before I make any rash moves. Honestly, keeping these party heals up is working really well. I think having a marking party for this run is going to do you good. And of course, that's one where you can... we can't hit that with this guy, so we do this. That's one where you have several units that can benefit from a single mark. Which is working. To my surprise. Please, no bleed. Good, no bleed. So we throw this at you, hope to not underroll. We did underroll. Fudge. We could try and get away with hitting it with the Vestal, but it's 59%. What's the accuracy on this? 110. I think, honestly, we have to make sure that it dies. Ah, you see?
The match is struck.
Chance of that not working and then this not working? Oh, for fuck's sake. Massive crit for 1 HP. I'm not worried about the HP of our party at the moment. As long as we can keep killing that Fusilier, we're fine. So our specific HP is sort of transient, basically. Again. As long as we're keeping on doing this, we're not hitting the cannon. But we have to make sure the Fusilier dies, or we basically all die and we've got no chance. So I think, well, Dutch goes first, which is ideal here. Another crit. I think in this situation, I would actually prefer it if Dutch were going literally first. Ouch. You're going to have to heal yourself straight up. For literally that one round back, which is really annoying. But we can't afford to use Dutch to heal the Vestal, because then Dutch doesn't get to shoot this bastard. So we put the mark back on this. We're nearly there. Okay, we're not dead yet. I mean, we're not... I hate to, you know, tempt fate, but we're not that close to death either. And whenever that works, we get basically a free round of damage on this. A good amount of damage, anyway. Debuff here is doing less dodge. I mean, that's okay. I can live with it. This debuff here is less bleed resist. Also okay. So now we sniper shot this to get as much damage done to it as possible. And you're back on the chain gang. You've got less dodge, but you've got less literal HP. And if you die, we all die, so let's not let that happen. Reinforcements are back. As long as this thing only gets to do reinforcements, which I think is all it can do, then we're happy. Collect bounty is the one we want here. 8 damage. I mean, that's a pretty decent amount of damage for something that is made of actual iron. Perfect. So glad that missed, because I'm tired of undoing it. Couldn't you dodge? No. Ooh. Don't appreciate that at all. Do we rely on Dutch not missing? How much damage is this going to do? 47. Ah, shit. No, we don't. We can't assume that would happen. And if Dutch, if that didn't work, we could use Dutch. But this can still do, you know, 3-7 damage. So. It's only the positioning right now that's a great big deal. And of course, apparently we can still party heal and get a crit. So that's pretty good. That was basically like healing yourself and then everybody else. Blanket fire. Some dodges? Yeah. I'm hoping that Dutch does get to go a little bit earlier than everybody else, or at least we could just kill this thing and have done with it. That was a 4-9 roll. I'm going to keep doing this. Yeah, because again, if that doesn't work, we use Dutch. And we can always use the Vestal to do this last bit of damage here, in fact. If we wanted to. That's not going to work. So we'll keep healing the way we were going to heal anyway, which is party heal till the cows come home. So honestly, this position is not that bad. Plus, it's two rounds before we can get Erasmus back into the position we want them to. Unless we simply go ahead and just... Wow! What a fucking way to finish that fight! I love it. Right now, we troll the shit out of these motherfuckers. Have you got a dodge? You got a dodge. I didn't realize it had such high dodge. We've been very lucky. What have we got here? 4 to 8. 6 to 12. Done. Yeah! We're beating the shit out of these with fucking crits right at the end. Yeah, try it. See if I give a shit. Bring it the hell on. Can't stand my ground. Blind fire. Nah. Come on, Dutch. We needed to knock that one out in the perfect end to this horrendous run. Ooh. Seize this some free momentum. Shit. Push on to the task's end. Don't need this. We'll take this. Probably not going to keep that. We'll continue adventuring because we still have this key. And I have not forgotten. Ooh, interesting. That there is a curio. I think we want to open that one. So let's go back. When we get to it, we can discard our torches. We're going to use our key. We can get rid of any food that we may have left, which I think we do. Yeah, we've got 6 left. So we may get a hunger between now and then, so I'm glad that we've got that food left. Get rid of that too, if we wanted to. This has gone really, really well. I was actually expecting to have a horrific time with this. Let's put ourselves back in order, in case we get a random encounter that something's respawned or something. We haven't got anything left. In that case, I'm not going to do it, in case we get a disease or something. We don't have any anti-venom, so we can't protect ourselves from it. And then final journey here. We've only got one key, so I won't open this one unless we're forced to. In which case, we can't use a key anyway, so it doesn't matter. We'll end up down here, and we'll pop in here, and we'll open up this chest with this key. And it contains fuck all. Some decent stuff. But we can take it all anyway, so... Cool, I guess. Let's leave. That was a great mission. I'm super happy that we actually made the leap there and actually tried to do that. 5, 10, 15, 20, 30, 2,000! That's a lot of money. Pretty pleased with that. So you've got ennui, which is a disease, of course. You've got the runs, which is a fucking disease, of course. Demonomania believes is possessed by demons. I think that'll mean that you will start trying to do confessions and use eldritch altars and things like that. We've got 2 level 5s and a level 4 out of that. Which is okay, but now all our units are really high level and we can't do any more missions. The town is alive with wild merriment. Fuck! Do it! Did you see that shit? Zeke was caught making strange requests. Replaced. Love interest. With what? Does that mean that they're not allowed to go there anymore? Zeke, where are you? Deviant tastes. Yeah, not allowed to visit the brothel. But love interest meant you would only visit the brothel, so... fair enough. Now everything's... This is impossible. Right, oh my god. Free. Get in there. I've never thought this would happen. Wow. Make the fucking most of it right now. I'm even considering putting Payus there in somewhere. Fucking everyone. Free. I've got enough units that don't need this that I do not care how many I put in here. The only concern is that all these people are like, oh shit. We'll only flagellate. Oh, bollocks. This is the worst time. Oh, it's free though, so whatever. You, get out. Shit, it's free. Good. Decline. Get in here. I'm there, Ed. You fucking dick. Are you serious? God-fearing will only pray. Maybe we can just expand this. Oh, it's you. Who's in there? Holmesy. Where are you? will only pray, right? So we can't do both of them without expanding that. So maybe we can? Oh, thank God for that. If there was ever a time when that needed to be possible, it was now, and we did it. So I'm super pleased with that. So everyone else has to fit in the tavern, basically. Megistos will go in the tavern. This is perfect. I mean, I could just start putting people in who are slightly, you know, slightly worried. I mean, maybe Dutch deserves going for a brothel for doing so well in the previous run, which actually I am extremely pleased with his performance on. Payas, I want to take you on the next run, to be fair. In fact, all of you. Maybe we'll take Penelope Puddles for once. We've got enough level 3s to take this level 2 unit off on a stuff-gathering run. And then we're going to get rid of Payas anyway, so we don't really need to put them in for any sort of treatment. Let's sort by stress. Pete. Sure. Pete, you haven't been in for treatment for quite a long time. Psycho. We'll only flagellate. Let me fill that up, though. Yeah. Can we upgrade it? With 11 busts. So if we replace... Yeah. Oh, now I'm going to... Bollocks. So now we have to switch these... for these. Great.
A man in a robe, claiming communion with the divine.
Wow, okay.
Madness.
What absolute perfect timing. Is this free? Is this free? Shit me, this is free. Oh my shit, this is free. Everyone, in! Jekri, how long have you had bad humours? Here you go. Ooh, can we get rid of anything else? We haven't used Jekri for a while, actually. We should put all these people in. I tell you what we should do. We should use this to enforce some good quirks for once in our goddamn lives. We can actually burn in a good quirk of a unit who is benefiting from them. So all these people aren't going to get that done because they're all in somewhere else. So Marty's the first one we can do that to. Fast healer is okay. Meh. Meh. That's pretty nice. That could be worth keeping. What else we got? Manslayer. Natural swing. More damage in Cove. That's pretty good. More crit. DT. That's pretty nice. I mean, many of these are not actually that great. It's kind of annoying, to be honest with you. That's pretty good. I think I might burn that one in if there's nothing better. Scrounging, crit. That's just more crit in general, because all your skills are melee, which is great. I think at this stage... Why are you... Oh, we saw it by stress, of course. I'm still thinking that... I think it was Erasmus has the best thing here. You haven't got any fucking quirks at all. What's the matter with you? Slugger. More melee. These are pretty nice. I'm thinking we make sure... That's no good, actually. We want to get rid of that. That Erasmus keeps... Was it that? I've forgotten already. I think just straight up 10% damage on Erasmus is really good, so I'm going to keep that. 10% damage of Torch Buff 75. Commit the hero for treatment. Now we'll lock that in. And we've got one more person, one more slot to get somebody. Probably not one of these people. Well, let's start by level. Taking full advantage of this. Just watch. Jeez Louise. You're in. You. Less damage on range skills. More stress damage is probably bad. But these delusions where people keep doing stuff is really annoying. Maybe we get rid of that on you. Damage's not that useful. Severe fear of enclosed spaces, which is everywhere. also a problem. Actually, we should probably get rid of this one because it's so strongly burned in. Oh, it's diseases. What am I doing? Mistake. All right, who's got a disease? Marie, you've got a disease. Got two diseases. So there's a chance that for free, we'll get rid of both of them. Probably this one. Well, what an opportunity has arisen today. We have, what is this? My memos. We have just very luckily had an opportunity. All stress relief activities and fucking sanitarium activities cost us zero, which means we get to keep all of this shit and basically invest in everybody in one at once, all at once. No, I assume that just means that these are not free, right? Which is fine. They can be not free. They can be as not free as they want to be. But I guess we decide what to do with these people in the next episode. But I'm so pleased with this episode that I'm going to upload it twice. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.